Hey everyone, I'm here today at Darkly Labs yet again, but instead of being up in the office, we're downstairs here in the assembly room, and I'm here with my friend Ben, and we are going to assemble an Emblaser Core. For those of you who don't know what an Emblaser Core is, it is actually a kit model of the world famous Emblaser, and it takes a little bit of a different direction, because if you're a maker or if you're interested in laser cutters, this kit will actually teach you the basics of what goes on in the laser cutter itself. Before we actually start building this Emblaser Core, I invite you guys to hit the subscribe button and the bell icon so you don't miss any maker videos about laser cutting and maker culture. Now there is a few differences. We're looking at the core itself has all the mechanisms that the Emblaser has. So it's the same laser core, it's the same electronics, but it doesn't have the same safety features. So this is a laser cutter that you need to be aware of what's going on at all times. I'm really excited to get this made. Yeah. How about you?
Yes, good? Sir.
Right? It's gonna take us a few hours to make this, but let's jump straight into it. Right now we have all the parts that you need for your Emblaser. They're all organized in actual parts. So all your screws and your miscellaneous hardware is all here. You've also got all your 3D printed parts that actually make up a lot of the mechanisms. You've got your silicon mats, which actually go around this way, and you put your material on this. These are so handy in so many different ways. We're about to put together the main body of the Emblaser Core right now. All the instructions for this kit are online, so we may be looking at this computer right here just to make sure we're doing things right. All the parts are laid out, and we're going to build this machine step by step and show you exactly how easy it is to get your Emblaser Core up and running. So you want to make sure that when you're putting this together that this big notch is on the left-hand side of your machine. So this is the back and this is the front. So given that this is the front, let's turn this around. And let's get the side panels on. So guys, we were doing this, we were in a bit of a hurry. You can see we've done these panels, and these panels are actually out on the side. That's actually incorrect. These panels need to rotate in so that we can have them in the right orientation. In our eagerness to get this made up, we actually put it on the wrong orientation. We're just gonna loosen up these nuts and just move them straight into the right one. So we're gonna do that right now. Okay, so we got the orientation correct with the brackets, and what we're going to do now is we're going to put cable holders in its place and then put the top on. So at this point you can see that the body of the Emblaser Core is a little bit different. We have access at the front and the back and at the sides. Now that we've got the motors, the stepper motors, into the Emblaser Core, we're actually going to put in these plugs, and these plugs are the guide rails. So the rails will actually go up and down, and these just happen to lock straight in beside the stepper motors. So we're going to do that right now. Right, Right now we're going to assemble the upper and lower idle pulleys. These have to be done separately. We've actually laid them in the order that they need to be assembled. So you take a bearing, place that on top. And can you see how it's made a small kind of area here? That's where the belt actually goes on. And then you get a tube, a very, very small washer. We actually don't need a bolt. They're going to be bolted into the machine. On the actual lower one, we actually use the tube first, and then we build that assembly in the same way. So one more done, you can see the difference. Tube first, bearings, and then washers. And now we have all the guides ready to install. So right now we're going to install those guides that we just made into the machine. If you take a look at the front here, you can see there's no Emblaser Core sticker. So that's the back, this is the front. And there's a little bit of a trick, because what we actually want to do is we want to put the upper on one side, and then the opposite guide is actually the lower. So it goes high to low, and then low to high. So what we're going to actually do is I'm going to put this first one in, and it's actually in there right now. So that's a high, which means that I need to then go and get a low, which is this one here, and place it in there. I then need to do the opposite of that. I need to take a high one, so that's one with the tube at the bottom, put it in there, and then grab the last one and put the low in there. This is documented in the instructions, but I just wanted to make sure that we went over it now, because this is really confusing, and I just wanted to make sure that when you build your Emblaser Core, you have an idea of what to look out for. We're actually at the part now where we're going to work with the linear rails and the gantry carriages. In the instructions, it actually says that you will have to make up these gantries, but from now on, they come pre-made, and that's them right there. They slide up and down the rails, and we're going to install them along with the laser carriage, and this is the mechanism where the laser sits at the front and moves up and down. Now that we've got the first belt in place, we actually need to tension it. And we have a block here where the belt slides in, but one of the things we have to keep an eye on is that on the left-hand side, it needs to be 5 mil away from the actual body itself. As I pull this belt, you can see that it moves. So I'm just gonna place it in the correct space, then I'm going to gently put a little bit of tension on it and slide it into the block. Wow, it's actually a little trickier than I expected, but you just gently slide it in there. And then when I check it, I have 5 mil on this side, this side's flat, we're ready to go to the next part. Okay, so at this point, we've actually got the belts all tensioned and tightened. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna place this block in to the laser carriage, and it just clips in like that. And now we just gotta test it. So it's literally just moving back and forth. It moves easily and cleanly. I can see the belts moving and move forward and back. Brilliant. So we now have the carriage assembly and the motors in place. So we're now at the point where you can break out your laser unit. This is pretty exciting stuff. We're actually using an Emblaser 2 laser unit, so your unit will come with a completely different lens system. We just don't have one on hand right now. Over here, we actually have the mount, and if you look at the bottom here, there's a little screw hole. So I have a screw here, and we're going to attach it just onto the carriage like that, and then my job is to put the screw inside here and lock it down. We're going to put the switches in to the control board we just put on the back part of the Emblaser. These are my favorite part. I love buttons. Anything that lights up to me is really cool. So we have a power button and we have an engage button. All you gotta do here is just take the nut off and then drop the button in. And then from the other side, just thread that nut back up and lock it. It's that simple. Something I used to love to do on the arcade machines I used to build. Bin here is just taking the flexible cable and is actually running it through the main body of the machine so that we can actually get the controller board in there. There you go. And at this point we take the case, which we fold it up. Okay, put the ribbon cable through. Ben's now actually putting spaces into the sleeve to allow the board to sit without touching. Just by pushing it on, it's now secured to the machine. Once all the cables are put together, we just fold up the box and these tabs come together and you have one very neat electronics package. So it's been a couple of hours. It's been about 4 or 5 hours putting this all together. We've got the electronics package in, we've got the gantry in, we've got the laser in. So all we need to do at this point is finish the project, and that's by putting this incredibly heavy metal base onto the machine. So that's a really hard thing to do. I'm just gonna place this over here like that and start using some M3 bolts to line it up, lock it in. And then the next part in this project is going to be testing the laser and seeing if we can get a result out of it. Well, it's been a really full day here down at Darkly Labs. We were able to put together the Emblaser core. Took about 5 hours, about between 4.5 to 5 hours. We made a few mistakes at the start. We showed you those, and we also showed you how not to make those mistakes when you go through this process yourself. Now we've got the machine here, we've got power to it. Really all we need to do at this point is actually turn it on. It lights up, the fan's working, that's a great sign. And I like the fact that the machine is now doing its own test. It is now. So let me quickly show you and talk to you about some of the differences between this machine and the normal Emblaser. As you can see here, there are very open areas, which means that I can take a piece of material and I can actually pass it through, so I don't have to just cut material that sits on the actual bed itself. The other part about it is there is no lid on this machine, which means that if someone can see the laser, then they are potentially in danger of damaging their eyes. Every machine comes with a pair of glasses. They come with the machine. If you are going to use this machine around with a whole bunch of other people, then I strongly suggest you purchase a few more of these glasses, because if they come into the room, you're cutting, and they can see that blue laser, and our eyes are incredibly sensitive. Really, the last thing that we need to do on this machine right now is to actually cut something. So I'm going to put in the mats and get some paper, and let's see if we can actually cut a design out on this newly made Emblaser core. Okay, so that was our first test with this Emblaser Core. You know what? I'm actually really impressed. This was a quick test with a piece of paper. It worked literally, I'm gonna say out of the box, but out of the construction, first time. There was literally nothing we had to do to make sure that this machine wouldn't work. Now, one of the things that really strikes me about this machine compared to the normal Emblaser is the fact that when we were cutting the paper, you can actually smell the burning. And I realized that the Emblaser has extraction outside of window or to a filter. This machine doesn't. So you want to keep that in mind when you're using this machine. If you're going to use it in your workshop, especially if you're going to cut anything that may be plastic or dangerous, please check it beforehand. And we will have a link to a video on how to do a spot check really quickly. If you've come this far and you've seen us create this machine and you're interested in one yourself, we have a special offer for you. So check down in the description below and you will have a link to be able to get one of these machines and a very special offer since you watched this whole video. Lastly, I want to thank Darkly Labs for allowing me to come in and play. I want to thank Ben, who is incredible at being able to make this. I always love building with people, and Ben is just amazing when it comes to building this sort of stuff. And lastly, I want to invite you guys to hit that subscribe button and that bell icon, because I don't want you to miss these types of videos that bring you behind the scenes when it comes to equipment, technology, workflow, and maker culture. It's been an absolute blast. I can't wait to get this into my workshop, to get a second laser that will allow me to put different materials in the front and the back. I'm gonna grab a few more sets of glasses because I think these glasses make me look good. And I'm gonna see you guys real soon. Go out and make something.